I was happy with two putts there.
That looked like all shoulders. That was good. We were just talking about that.
This is my friend that I've been playing with played with once at Bear Creek.
Oh.
Berry Country Club, sorry. And he's down here a lot. I've seen him a lot practicing on the range, so he's determined to get better.
That's right. As old as you get, you gotta just keep trying. Good to see you, buddy.
Yeah, you too.
All the best.
Thank you. So the eighth hole here is a 450-yard par 4. It's downhill only once you get to about the 120-yard mark. So I'm not gonna hit a 330-yard drive. I'm just trying to get in the fairway and have a nice shot at the green. Pulls a little shorter, goes the pins at the front. I'm just gonna try to hit a nice draw. Wind's coming from the right. Should give me a little extra distance. Going down the middle. Yep, just down the left side of the fairway. I can't really tell you how far I have in. Less than 170, I can tell you that. Pin's not really in the front, it's more in the middle, but I got 155 to the pin. I'm slightly downhill. I'm gonna choke down on a 7. Just because the 8 might go a little too high. You know what? It might just be a full 7, considering all the other yardages I've been hitting lately. Let's get it on the green. Ledge just left of the pin's a little better. It's an uphill putt. Just try to miss left a little bit more.
See how it's a bit chunky?
Chunky and left.
Yeah.
Short of the green. We'll hit that second shot a little chunky. I've just gone up and it's to the green. It's a little bit uphill, right to left. I'm gonna use a pitching wedge. So uphill, when these greens are uphill, they're kind of slow. Which meaning when they're downhill, they're fast. So right to left. Hopefully I get it up there nice and close so I can make my putt far. Yep, it's about a foot. It's a tap in par. Stay 200. Happy with the par. I got my chip shot up there nice and close, and I used the club that wouldn't check up on me. Ninth hole here, 491 yards. It's short, but it's uphill, straight uphill to the green. So it probably plays at like 530, 520. Drive up the left is a little better, just to keep the ball in play. But if you wanted a better angle to the pin, you want to be up the right. But there is OB right. I'm just gonna play a nice baby cut starting up the left side so that I can keep it in the middle of the fairway. Yep. I hit that one really good too. That's in the fairway, I think. It's kind of hard to see because the bunker blocks out my view of the fairway. But I hit it good, and I think I'm in the fairway. I hit it exactly the way I wanted to, which is a, it's probably the best feeling in golf, hitting a shot the way you want to. So I absolutely killed that drive. I have 195 to the pin, but to get to the front edge of the green, which is a lot better than being long, is 170. So I'm gonna hit a 4-iron. If I hit a 5-wood, it would be really hard to control uphill and off of a cut lie. And it's just a little too short to hit that 5-wood, I think. But I'm gonna get my dad to go up there, because as you can see, if I hit the shot, you wouldn't be able to see where it finished.
That drive of Carl certainly was out of the screws. He's hit that to good 30, 40 yards further than he has been. This is 4-iron, and he can't see it. Oh, here we go. You see how that ball's just feeding forward on its own. Now that putt that Carl's got now is just going to take off. He was using a 4-iron there because he didn't want to be having this downhill putt. He was hoping for his 4-iron, or expecting his 4-iron to be a bit further, closer to the front of the green. But he's got two putts there for a bird. So Carl's putt's just going to take off as soon as he hits it. He actually landed just off the green, Carl.
Yeah.
And kicked right after it landed. Carl was looking for his pitch mark, but he actually landed left of the green, and it's fed on. But you guys have already seen that from the previous frame. Yeah, this is a treacherous downhill left to right putt. So two putts would be absolute gold. One putt would be Christmas. Now somebody raised a point recently about whether you're allowed to use your putter to clear this stuff off the green. You can use your putter as long as you're not improving your the line that you've got by pressing firmly on the green. Speed was pretty good.
I pushed it, but
speed was pretty good, but he didn't start it left enough.
Good speed, I guess.
So about 3 feet there for his birdie, and this will be left to right breaking. Good birdie.
So I two putt birdie there. I was a little disappointed with my first putt just because I pushed it. It's one of those putts where you know it's gonna break a lot, but you just have that last second instinct to kind of come out of it because you don't feel like it's gonna break that much, but you know it's gonna break that much. Still happy with a two-putt birdie. Go 3-under, 33 on the front. Believe it or not, that is actually the first time I have shot under par on this 9. And the second 9 that we're about to play, I've never shot over par on. So hopefully this round can go a lot lower. Tenth hole here is a 406-yard par 4. Once you reach it about 150 to the, or no, like 120 yards to the pin, it drops straight down to the green. Driver's the club just because it's colder, and I'm hitting it straighter than my 3-wood. So, up the left side with a baby cut is the ideal play. Not really cutting. As you can see, the whole entire left side of the hole kicks right, and that's exactly what it did. That is why left is a better miss. If you go anywhere up the right side, you're dead and in the hazard. So I think I'm just in the rough or in the fairway, but at least I have a good shot of the green.
Oh,
down 105 yards. I just missed the fairway and I'm in the rough, unfortunately. But I have a nice clear shot at the green. It's probably gonna be a full sand wedge. Out of the rough, downhill. Get it on the green and a two putt for par. Yeah, you make a birdie. I knew I struck it perfect as soon as I hit the ball. I took a little off it, but I'm not complaining. It's a 2-3 feet for birdie. Go 4 under.
So this is the view back to the tee box. So Carl's hugging the left-hand side here, knowing that the camber of the fairway is just going to pull the ball back in onto the fairway. It didn't actually pull his on, but he was only 10, 15 feet off. So you'll see Carl fixing up more than just his pitch mark here. We'll normally try and fix up at least one other one while he's here.
So wasn't much in that putt, maybe just inside right and firm, but take me 4 under through 10 holes, and maybe it's just the good luck of the course vlog, but I'm playing good today. So this hole is a 414 yard par 4. The overall yardage of this course is about 7,025 yards, but overall 7,025 yards isn't a long course, but in the winter, that 7,025 yards becomes a lot longer. So here, anywhere up the middle is good. Slight dogleg right and uphill, so it plays more than 414. Right rough, I kind of blocked it a little, but it could be in the fairway, but I'm gonna say more likely just in the right rough.